It's the 6th annual MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee. It is kicking off right now. We've got 24 finalists from all over the country. We're going to get one winner out of this evening who's going to get a $10,000 check, by the way.
This is our, I believe, fifth consecutive year being the title sponsor for this event.
Because, you know, just sitting through the first round, everyone is so good. It's tough.
It's a wonderful feeling to see all these wonderful contestants on the stage.
We're presenting two tickets to India and back to any destination.
I chew my nails up. I have my child here sitting and doing the same things.
I'm very nervous and also excited at the same time for all the finalists.
I think it's a great family program to watch and be a part of.
Because it's like a sporting event. You start to sweat. You're rooting for everybody. You want it to go to overtime. You don't quite want anyone to lose, but it's wonderful.
Within the hour, we should have our winner. And then that will mean that that person has not spelled any word incorrectly since the start of the journey of the South Asian Spelling Bee this season.
Please welcome your host tonight, business anchor with New York One and host of the hit show AVS, Miss Joya Das.
Good evening and welcome to the 2013 MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee Finals. I'm Joya Das, and conducting the contest today is a panel of judges and a pronouncer. Our pronouncer this evening is Barney Galassio, Vice President of Medco Health Solutions in Franklin Lakes, New Jersey. Barney has been a New Jersey Bee announcer and judge for many years and is returning this year as our pronouncer for the finals of the South Asian Spelling Bee. Our judges, they return this year as well. Judge Miguel De La Carrera, a judge of the Superior Court of the State of New Jersey. Mrs. Vandana Walia, author as well as retired English teacher. And Mrs. Louise Silverman, retired college professor, Ocean County College. Please give them a big round of applause. And now please join me in welcoming the founder of the South Asian Spelling Bee and the CEO of Touchdown Media, Mr. Rahul Walia.
Thanks, Joya. Ladies and gentlemen, this event would not have been possible without the support of our sponsors and the people that dedicate their time and energy in building a cutting-edge event that is broadcast and enjoyed by audiences in over 120 countries. Over the last 2 months, we have been busy conducting the search for our champion. The path began with spellers registering themselves to participate at the regionals, and from there, the top two winners became finalists. In all, there were 12 centers that included Los Angeles, the Bay Area, Dallas, Houston, Chicago, Seattle, Atlanta, Orlando, DC Metro, New Jersey, New York, and Boston. And today we have with us winners from each of those centers. I'd like to request all of you to please join me in welcoming the 24 finalists of the 2013 MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee. Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause for these finalists. Before we start, let's have a quick look at how we got here tonight.
Okay, so how'd you hear about the spelling bee?
She told me.
My mom found out about it on Facebook and she told me.
Saw it last year and the year before on Sony TV.
To be honest, my manager found out these consults
I win, I'm gonna scream as loud as I can.
My favorite etymology is German.
Latin.
German. I like Greek.
English.
French. Probably Greek or Latin.
French.
Latin, I guess. Arabic.
Welsh.
Latin.
French.
I don't like German, but it's...
This is our first time here, so we'll see how it goes.
This is my sixth time.
Whether winning or losing is not that important, but participation, which will make him, stronger.
And actually to get an experience and make some new friends, definitely.
I think it gives them better ability to express themselves.
I'll most likely save most of it.
Gonna buy something at GameStop.
Buy an iPad mini.
I don't know, shop with it.
College or soccer stuff.
Save it for college.
I'm gonna give the money to my parents.
I'm gonna buy toys with it.
I'd probably just save it for like future use, you know, tuition, things like that.
I have no idea.
I was a little nervous throughout the day, but I had so much fun.
I'm really glad that I came second and I'm going to the nationals.
I was a little nervous, but then it got good.
One, I'm sleepy, and two, I'm really happy.
Well, it feels good, but then it's like I was so close to, you know, winning.
And now please welcome our 2012 national champion, Mr. Semantic Pyra. Hello, Semantic. So since you're the reigning champion, do you want to tell us about the rules tonight?
It's pretty simple, Rahul. The contest will be conducted orally on a miss and out basis. Simply, if a speller misspells their word, they are out of the contest. During the oral contest, a speller is entitled to ask the pronouncer to repeat the word, define the word, use the word in a sentence, provide the part of speech, and provide the languages of origin. Once the speller is ready, they must repeat the word back before and after spelling, and the speller cannot retract his or her letters once they have begun spelling.
Okay, well, Semantic, are you ready to give over your crown to the new champion?
Yes, I am.
Okay, well, let's wish them good luck. Good luck,
spellers. Good luck, guys.
My name is Atharva Patil, and I'm from Los Angeles, California. I like doing sports such as swimming and basketball.
Personnel.
May I have the definition?
Personnel are volunteers or employees working with a particular group or company.
Can I have the origin, please?
This went from Latin to Middle English, French, and finally to German.
Personnel. P-E-R-S-O-N-N-E-L, personnel.
Correct.
I'm Moses Alexander, speller number two. I'm from Washington, D.C. I like playing soccer, riding my bike, and watching TV. May the best speller win.
Accommodate.
Could you use it in a sentence?
Yes. Seatbelts accommodate people of practically every size.
Could you please repeat the word?
Accommodate.
Accommodate. A, C, C, O, M, M, O, D, A, T, E, accommodate.
Correct.
My name is Alina Baiju, and I like to read, ice skate, draw, and play the clarinet and piano. The first thing is just don't be nervous, because that's just going to make you worse.
Pharaoh.
Pharaoh, may I please have the definition?
This is a ruler of ancient Egypt.
Mm-hmm. May I please have the language of origin?
Went from Latin to Greek and ended up in Hindi.
Pharaoh. P-H-A-R-A-O-H. Pharaoh.
Correct.
My name is Chaitin Reddy and I'm number four. I enjoy playing a lot of sports. I play basketball, football, cricket, just recreationally. So, good luck to everybody. You're all going to need it.
Accolades.
Accolades. Can I have the definition, please?
A mark of acknowledgement, award, or bestowal of praise, often in plural form.
Accolades can have the part of speech.
Noun.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Yes. The word props seems similar to giving someone accolades for a great accomplishment.
Accolades. A C C O L A D E S. Accolades.
Correct.
My name is Aditya Mishra. I'm number 5, and I am from Lincoln, California. I love to mountain bike and read.
Boulevard.
Boulevard. B-O-U-L-E-V-A-R-D. Boulevard.
Correct.
I'm Shriram Hathwar. I'm number 6, and I'm from Painted Post, New York. I like to ski and skate because I live in the Northeast, and I also like to swim.
Perfunctory.
Perfunctory. Perfunctory. P-E-R-F-U-N-C-T-O-R-Y. Perfunctory.
Correct.
Hi, my name is Dave Jaiswal. I'm speller number 7, and I'm from Louisville, Mississippi. I like to read, sing, act, and play basketball and karate.
Buccaneer.
Buccaneer? Buccaneer. B-U-C-C-A-N-E-E-R. Buccaneer?
Correct.
Thank you.
Kirthi Radhakrishnan, number 8, and I'm from Middletown, New York. This competition's gonna decide who's the best South Asian speller, so good luck, everyone.
Anoint.
Wait, what?
Anoint.
What was the word?
Mm-hmm. Anoint.
May I have the definition?
Yes. Anoint means to choose by, or as if by, divine election.
Anoint?
Anoint, yes.
Okay, may I have the language of origin? That's what I was trying to say.
Yeah, Latin to Middle French on to Middle English.
Okay, then. Anoint. A-N-O-I-N-T. Anoint.
Correct.
Hi, I'm Neha Shashadri. I'm speller number 9, and I'm from Detroit, Michigan. Hi, I've worn my lucky beer earrings, so good luck, and may the best speller win.
Puce.
Puce. P-U-C-E. Puce.
Correct.
Hi, I'm Sharmita Dixit, and I'm number 10, and I was the first runner-up at the Chicago Regionals.
Bouillon. Bouillon.
Bouillon. Bouillon. B-O-U-I-L-L-I-O-N. Bouillon.
I'm sorry, you added a letter. Off by one letter. B-O-U-I-L-L-O-N.
Hey, I'm Swetha Pola. I'm speller number 11 from South Brunswick, New Jersey. I love art. I play volleyball. I dance Bollywood and hip hop. I also play the clarinet.
Pariah.
Pariah. P-A-R-I-A-H. Pariah.
Correct.
Hi, my name is Shirav Dasari. I'm number 12 and I'm from Houston, Texas. Be careful because I'm gonna win this.
Labyrinth.
Labyrinth. L-A-B-Y-R-I-N-T-H, labyrinth.
Correct.
I'm Sherlyn Pavahar from Bay Area. My message to fellow contestants is, it's us versus the dictionary, don't let the dictionary win.
Calluses.
Calluses. C-A-L-L-U-S-E-S. Calluses.
Correct.
It is the day of. We are behind the scenes at the MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee, and with me right now is the founder and CEO of Touchdown Media.
What we have seen now in our sixth year is that children that the spellers that started with us when they were 8 or 7 years old are now in the finals. So they have had their commitment and their diligence in participating at the South Asian Spelling Bee since they were 7 or 8 years old.
I'm Shobha Dasari, I'm number 14 and I'm from Pearland, Texas. I like to read, I like to draw, and I like to practice Indian classical dance.
Acolytes.
Acolytes? Yes. Can I have the definition, please?
Altar boy or girl, or an assistant, often young, to the minister or priest.
Acolytes. A-C-O-L-Y-T-E-S. Acolytes.
Correct.
Hi, my name's Gokul Venkatachalam. I'm number 15 and I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. I like to play basketball and play soccer.
Malachite.
Malachite. M-A-L-A-C-H-I-T-E. Malachite.
Correct.
I'm Shreya Nerudavolu. I do piano, dance, and singing, and I just like a lot of music-related things. May the best speller win, and good luck to everyone.
Lucre. Lucre.
Lucre. Am I saying it correctly?
Very well.
Lucre. Can I have the origin?
Went through many languages. Sanskrit, Greek, Old Irish, Old Gothic, Old Norse, Old English, and finally Middle English.
Lucre. L-U-C-R-E. Lucre.
Correct.
Hi, I'm Neil Kovalamudi, speller number 17 from San Jose, California. Spell well and let's have fun.
Chastise. Chastise.
Chastise? Am I saying it correctly?
Just, I want it a little slower on the end. Chastise.
Chastise.
Yes.
Chastise. C H A S T I S E. Chastise.
Correct.
Hi, I'm Sarah Beyer. I'm number 18 and I'm from Franklin, Massachusetts. I enjoy basketball, drama, student government, reading, writing, hanging out with my friends, and just having fun. 1, 2, 3, 4, I declare a spelling war. 5, 6, 7, 8, you're all good, but I'm great.
Cadre.
Cadre. May I have the definition, please?
This is a core group of trained personnel or active members of an organization.
Cadre. C-A-D-R-E. Cadre.
Correct.
I'm Sidon Chari. Good luck and may the best speller win.
Vilify.
Vilify. Vilify. V-I-L-L-I. F-Y, vilify.
I'm sorry, you added a letter.
One, just one L, V-I-L-I-F-Y.
I'm Ashwin Viramani, I'm number 20, and I'm from Cleveland, Ohio. Good luck and have fun, and may the best speller win.
Acumen, acumen.
Acumen. A. C-U-M-E-N, acumen.
Correct.
Hi, my name's Fiona Mishra, and I'm number 21, and I'm from Orlando, Florida. My advice is be the best bee you can be.
Abscess.
Abscess. A-B-S-C-E-S-S, abscess.
Correct.
My name is Lokesh Naganani. I am number 22 and I'm from Dallas, Texas. I enjoy swimming, playing tennis, and reading.
Dirge.
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 Dirge. D I R G E. Dirge.
Correct.
Hello, my name is Aditi Rao. I'm number 23 and I'm from Lopatcong, New Jersey. I like to read and write short stories and essays, and I enjoy table tennis.
Scoliosis.
Scoliosis. S-C-O-L-I-O-S-I-S.
S, scoliosis.
Correct.
My name is Shakti Kumarasan. My number is 24, and I'm from Shrewsbury, Massachusetts. I like to read, and I love to write stories.
Passé. Passé.
Passé. P-A-S-S-E. Passé.
Correct.
And that completes round number one. Let's give them a nice big round of applause.
Well, tell me a little bit about MetLife's involvement with the Spelling Bee.
This is our, I believe, fifth year, consecutive year, being the title sponsor for this event. We got the check ready and waiting to see how long it'll take.
In your estimation, do you think it's going to be like a death match in there?
I think it's going to be a long one. It's going to be a long one.
So, you know, we can't have a spelling bee where there are children that are 9, 10, 13, 14 without the parents. So we thought it'd be great if we actually heard from the parents first. Here you go.
We drove all the way from Michigan.
We're coming from Los Angeles.
Orlando, Florida.
Phillipsburg, New Jersey.
California.
I'm from Texas.
Boston.
Upstate New York.
Atlanta. San Francisco Bay Area.
Seattle, Washington.
Dallas, Texas.
I don't know whether if you notice, these kids, they make great friendships. So you can look at the table and how they bond to each other, because they all have the same interests, same intellectual abilities.
You know, it started only 5 years back. It's grown really well, and I'm very proud.
I was a parent who was initially not into spelling bee, so I am now totally into it. I think the bee bug has bitten my daughter.
And they're saying, why don't we prepare for next year? Well, let's start the preparation now.
I think this year the event is going to be so much fun.
I think it's exciting.
I like what they are doing.
It's been great. I think it's extremely well organized.
I see this is a well organized event, and everything is planned very well, and it's a very good opportunity for my daughter also to get to see other fellow competitors. We like everything here.
It will definitely help for the SAT. My daughter, she did a spelling bee and now she's preparing for college.
It's a very good platform for all the kids. Where they can actually excel and they can have fun too.
This South Asian Spelling Bee has given a lot of opportunities for children.
This is definitely a bigger platform than the other bees he has been at.
Oh, it's been great. We've been coming here for almost 5 years now, so this is our last chance, and it's been a great experience.
They conducted the competition in Orlando, in Florida, for the first time. So really, that's a good, like, it gives up a lot of opportunity to kids.
I think South Asian Spelling Bee should have more regions in the country, and maybe they can make it more international even.
And we can begin round number two with speller number one.
LA finalist Atharva Patil, who says life's mantra is, when there's a will, there is a way.
Tourniquet.
Tourniquet. T-O-U-R-N-I-Q-U-E-T, tourniquet.
Correct.
Antediluvian.
Could you please use it in a sentence?
Yes. Whether the city of Atlantis is simply an antediluvian myth, we'll never know.
Antediluvian. Am I saying it right?
Yes.
Antediluvian. A N T E D I L U V I A N, antediluvian.
Correct.
Inexorable. Inexorable.
Can you please use it in a sentence?
Yes. After being fired, he could not stop the inexorable tide of outgoing funds.
Inexorable. Am I saying this correctly?
Yes.
Inexorable. I-N-E-X-O-R-A-B-L-E, inexorable.
Correct.
Atomized.
Atomized.
Yes.
Atomized. A-T-O-M-I-Z-E-D, atomized.
Correct.
LA finalist Aditya Mishra. The spelling bee for me is a lot of fun, and life's mantra, People rarely succeed unless they have fun in what they are doing.
Idiosyncrasies.
Idiosyncrasies. IDIOSYNCRASIES. Idiosyncrasies.
Correct.
New York finalist Sriram Hathwar. If victorious, Sriram says, if I win, I will coach my brother to win as well.
Halcyon.
Halcyon. H-A-L-C-Y-O-N. Halcyon.
Correct.
Atlanta finalist Dave Jaiswal. The spelling bee for me is a fun puzzle and my passion. Life's mantra, a house divided against itself cannot stand.
Strychnine.
Strychnine?
Yes.
Strychnine. S-T-R-Y-C-H-N-I-N-E. Strychnine?
Correct.
Thank you.
Misogynistic.
Misogynistic?
Yes.
Okay, then. Misogynistic. M-I-S-O-G-Y-N-I-S-T-I-C. Misogynistic.
Correct.
Marauder.
Marauder?
Yes.
Okay, marauder. M-A-R-A-U-D-E-R. Marauder.
Correct.
New Jersey finalist Shweta Pola. Shweta says, the bee is fun, has literally made the dictionary my new best friend, and I'm honestly just really excited to meet everyone at Nationals.
Surfeit.
Surfeit. May I get the language of origin?
Latin to Middle French on to Middle English.
Okay, thank you. Surfeit. S-U-R-F-E-I-T. Surfeit.
Correct.
Milieu. Milieu.
Milieu. Milieu. M-I-L-I-E-U. Milieu.
Correct.
Euchre.
Euchre. May I have the definition?
Euchre is a card game in which each player is dealt five cards, and the player or side that makes the trump must take three tricks to win a hand.
Euchre. E U C H R E. Euchre.
Correct.
Amortize.
Amortize. Amortize. A M O R T I Z E. Amortize.
Correct.
Ersatz.
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 E R S A T Z. Ersatz.
Correct.
Orlando finalist Shreya Nidadavalu. Shreya says the spelling bee for me is a mind-blowing roller coaster. If I win, I will scream for joy.
Milk toast. Milk toast.
Milk toast?
Milk toast.
Milk toast. M I L K T O A S T. Milk toast.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Close. M I L Q U E T O A S T.
Thank you.
Chiasmus. Chiasmus.
Chiasmus.
Yes, that's perfect.
C-H-I-A-S-M-U-S. Chiasmus.
Correct.
Scrimshaw.
Scrimshawed?
Nope. Scrimshaw.
Scrimshaw. S-C-R-I-M-S. H-A-W, scrimshaw.
Correct.
Pinochle.
Can you repeat that, please?
Yes. Pinochle.
Pinochle? Mm-hmm. P-I-N-O-C-H-L-E, pinochle.
Correct.
Propitiate. Propitiate.
Propitiate. P-I-N-O-C-H-L-E.
R-O-P-I-T-I-A-T-E? Propitiate.
Correct.
Dallas finalist Lokesh Naganeni. Lokesh says the spelling bee for me is a stage where I can challenge myself. If I win, study for the next big thing.
Ukulele.
Ukulele?
Yep.
Ukulele. U K U L E L E. Ukulele.
Correct.
Sisyphean.
Sisyphean. S I S Y P H E A N. Sisyphean.
Correct.
Boston finalist Shakti Kumaresan. Life's mantra, cooperation, as I am a strong believer of teamwork.
Bourgeoisie. Bourgeoisie.
Bourgeoisie.
No. Bourgeoisie.
Bourgeoisie.
Yes.
B O R S O I S E E.
Say it again.
Bourgeoisie.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Very tough word. Bourgeoisie is B-O-U-R-G-E-O-I-S-I-E.
Well, we're presenting 2 tickets to India and back to any destination.
What do you think this competition is going to look like?
Everyone is so good. So I'm firstly wondering what time I'll get home.
So we are kicking off the roundtable for the finals of the South Asian Spelling Bee in its 6th year.
Here in the Spelling Bee, I think I've made more friends in one day than I have, like, in a while.
I learned that I'm much more confident than I think I am.
Before I started preparing for the Spelling Bee, I was never a time manager. I would never plan ahead.
You don't go and beat other people. They get out on their own words.
I watched golf on the channel, and they keep playing their game. They don't get bothered by anyone else.
Everybody is going to be having their own word. They're going to spell their own word, but it doesn't matter what they spell. It's what you spell. And if you aren't confident with yourself, then that's the danger.
Even if you learn one word in the Spelling Bee, it's made your vocabulary that much stronger.
Even if we fail, we at least know that we tried our hardest, and that makes a huge difference.
So we'll begin round number 3 with speller number 1. Accoutrement. Accoutrement.
Can you please repeat?
Yes. Accoutrement.
May I have the language of origin?
French.
Can I have the definition, please?
Accoutrement is a soldier's equipment, clothing, or costume, especially the accessories.
Accoutrement. A-C-C-O-U-T-R-E-M-A-N-T. Accoutrement.
I'm sorry, off by one letter.
One letter. It ends in E-N-T. Not A-N-T.
Okay.
DC Metro finalist Moses Alexander. If victorious, Moses plans to put the money in a college fund.
Axoricide. Axoricide.
Axoricide. O X O I R I D E. Axoricide.
I'm sorry, that's not correct.
Tough word. Axoricide is U X O R I C I D E.
Oh.
Oniromancy. Oniromancy.
Oniromancy. Am I saying this correctly?
Yes, now you are.
Oniromancy. O-N-E-I-R-O-M-A-N-C-Y. Oniromancy.
Correct.
Dallas finalist, Chetan Reddy. The spelling bee for me is fun. And life's mantra, be yourself, everyone else is already taken.
Ledger domain.
Ledger domain, can I have the definition, please?
Sleight of hand, artful deception.
Ledger domain. L-E-G-E-R-D-E-M-A-I-N. Ledger domain.
Correct.
Miscegenation. Miscegenation.
Miscegenation. M I S E G I N A T I O N. Miscegenation?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Very close, a little tricky in the beginning. M I S C E G E N A T I O N.
Thank you.
Yarmulke. Yarmulke.
Yarmulke?
Yes.
May I have its language of origin, please?
Turkish to Polish to Ukrainian to Yiddish.
Yarmulke, am I saying it correctly?
You are.
Yarmulke. Y-A-R-M-U-L-K-E. Yarmulke.
Correct. Sheikdoms. Sheikdoms.
Kikums?
Sheikdoms.
Sheikdoms?
Yes, plural.
Dums. Okay, plural. S H I E K D O M S. Sheikdoms?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
The E and the I in the other order.
Thank you.
So they've not such great news right now. What's happening?
I wasn't expecting it, and then I wasn't expecting that it would get so hard so quickly.
Well, listen, I think that you are a really bright kid, and I think you're going to go far. You've got a good attitude.
Eiderdown.
What was the word?
Eiderdown.
Eiderdown.
Yes.
Like down.
That's the way it sounds.
Okay, yeah. Eiderdown. Okay.
Eiderdown. Eiderdown.
Eiderdown. E I D E R D O W N. Eiderdown.
Correct.
Seattle finalist Neha Seshadri. Neha says, if I win, I will take a trip to India, buy lots of presents for my grandparents, and donate some for the animals in the Humane Society.
Diphthong.
Diphthong. D I P H T H O N G. Diphthong.
Correct. Palimpsest. Palimpsest.
Palimpsest.
Yes.
Palimpsest. P-A-L-L-A-M-C-E-S-T. Palimpsest.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Tricky word. Palimpsest is P-A-L-I-M-P-S-E-S-T.
Okay, thank you.
So how do you feel? What happened out there?
Oh, I just never heard the word before.
You have like a real healthy attitude about this, you know what I mean? Like you've got other things going on.
Although it's my first and last year as South Asian, it's been fun, and I didn't never realize that I could have made it to nationals, and I did, and it was just a big surprise for me, and it's just been honestly a great journey.
Acquiesce.
Acquiesce. A-C-Q-U-I-E. S-C-E, acquiesce.
Correct. Renege.
Renege. R-E-N-E-G-E, renege.
Correct. Verisimilitude.
Verisimilitude. V-E-R-I-S-I-M-I-L-I-T-U. D-E, verisimilitude.
Correct. Aficionados. Aficionados.
Aficionados.
Perfect.
A-F-F-I-O-N-A-D-O-S.
C-I-O-N-A-D-O-S, aficionados.
I'm sorry, you added a letter.
Oh, just one F. A-F-I-C-I-O-N-A-D-O-S.
Thank you.
Bay Area finalist Neil Covelamudi. Neil says, the spelling bee for me is a pastime. I enjoy participating in bees whenever I have the chance.
Hegemony.
Hegemony.
Perfect.
H-E-G-E-M-O-N-Y. Hegemony.
Correct.
Insouciantly.
Insouciantly.
Yes.
I-N-S-O-U-C-I-A-N-T-L-Y. Insouciantly.
Correct.
D.C. Metro finalist Ashwin Viramani. Ashwin says, the spelling bee for me is fun. And life's mantra, life is a journey and not a destination. Enjoy every second of it.
Ennui. Ennui.
Ennui?
Yes.
Ennui. E-N-N-U-I. Ennui.
Correct.
Inchoate.
Inchoate?
No. Inchoate.
Inchoate?
Yes.
I-N-C-H-O-A-T-E? Inchoate?
Correct.
Sybaritic.
Sybaritic?
Yes.
Sybaritic. S-Y-B-A-R-I-T-I-C. Sybaritic.
Correct.
Schmaltzy.
Schmaltzy.
Yes.
S-C-H-M-A-L-T-Z-Y. Schmaltzy.
Correct.
That is correct. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a nice big round of applause.
We are here at the 6th annual MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee. And you know that an event on this scale cannot happen without some key sponsors. This is being broadcast on Sony TV.
As Sony, we have always been a forerunner for family entertainment. I think the Bee has been an accurate fit to our programming.
So what, on a personal note, as you're watching this competition, are you nervous? Are you scared?
I chew my nails up. I have my child here sitting and doing the same thing. So I think it's a great family program to be a part of.
What's the hardest word that you have come across in all the time that you've been preparing and competing?
I think that would be merd.
Kwedai.
Kung Hanev.
Zweeback.
Badinage.
Ballyhood.
Quesadilla.
Dysa.
Zugma.
Intermium.
Tyalogog, because that was the word I missed in the National Spelling Bee this year.
Speller number 15 brought to our attention that aficionados can also be spelled, and the dictionary allows it, with two Fs. So we will welcome Speller 15 back into the Bee. We will start round four with Speller number 3.
Atlanta finalist Alina Baiju. Alina says, the spelling bee for me is a game that's lots of fun and helps me learn many new things about many different languages that will help me as long as I live.
Blatherskite.
Blatherskite? B-L-A-T-H-E-R-S-K-I-T-E. Blatherskite.
Correct.
Cantala.
Kantala?
Kantala,
yes.
Can I have the language of origin?
Finnish.
Can I have the part of speech?
Noun.
Kantala. C-A-N-T-A-L-A. Kantala?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Kantala is a very tough word. K-A-N-T-E-L-E. Kantala.
Thank you.
Thank you.
New Jersey finalist Kirti Radhakrishnan. Kirti says, if I win, I will be surprised, and then I will save money for college.
Chardosh.
What was the word?
Chardosh.
Chargosh?
Chardosh, yes.
Which language is that?
Hungarian.
It's Hungarian. We have the meaning?
Chardosh is a Hungarian couple's dance to music in double time that starts very slowly and ends in a rapid whirl.
Okay, I have no idea how to spell this word, but I'll guess. Chargosh. C-Z-A-R-G-O-S-H. Chargosh?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
You're off to the right start, though. Muscarine.
Muscarine?
Nope. Muscarine. Muscarine.
Muscarine. M-U-S-C-H-A-R-I-N-E. Muscarine.
So close.
No H. Everything else was good.
Thank you so much, everybody.
Rudabach.
Grudabach?
Nope. Rudabach.
Rudabach?
Rudabach.
Can I have the definition?
A Rudabach is a reddish impala or ale goat.
Rudabach?
Yes.
Rudabach. R-O-O-D-E-B-O-K. Rudabach.
Correct.
Cymatricus.
Cymatricus. C-Y-M-O-T-R-I-C. H-O-U-S, Cymatricus.
Correct.
The hard words I do come across, I learn them and then they kind of become easy.
I ask for the language of origin and then usually that gives me some clues on how to spell it.
Well, I just remind myself that I'm doing the best I can and that usually always calms me down.
I just take an educated guess.
I just try to like calm down and I ask for everything and I try to piece everything together.
I sometimes have practice spelling bees with my brother.
You never know where you can find good words. I found a good word in a hotel room Bible yesterday.
I'm not sure, but whatever it is, it doesn't really matter. It just matters that you try your best.
Appoggiatura.
Appoggiatura. Can you use the word in a sentence?
Yes. Before an even or unaltered note, the appoggiatura generally receives its face value.
A, P, P, O, G, G, I, A, T, U, R, A. Appoggiatura.
Correct.
Gokul Venkatachalam. Gokul says, the spelling bee for me is a place to make new friends who have a similar passion for spelling.
Saccades.
Saccades?
Yes.
Saccades. S-A-C-C-A-D-E-S. Saccades.
Correct.
Poco curante.
May you use it in a sentence?
Most young men seem rather poco curante about the tidiness of their rooms, but some are very fastidious.
Poco curante. P-O-C-O-C-U-R-A-N-T-I. Poco curante.
I'm sorry. Oh,
it's very close. P-O-C-O-C-O-U-R-A-N-T-E.
Thank you.
Boston finalist Surabhi Iyer. Surabhi says, life's mantra, they can take everything from you, but they can't take away your knowledge or your love.
Gaius Cutis.
Gaius Cutis.
G-Y-A-S-C-U-T-U-S. Gyascutus.
Correct.
Caprifigs.
Caprifigs.
Perfect.
Caprifigs. C-A-P-R-I-F-I-G-S. Caprifigs.
Correct.
Orlando finalist, Siona Mishra. Siona says, if I win, I will spend about 3% of it on books and other fun stuff, and I will save the rest for college.
Tintinabulous.
Tintinabulous.
Perfect.
T-I-N. T-I-N. N-A-B-U-L-O-U-S. Tintinabulous.
Correct.
Calipigian. Calipigian.
Can you please repeat the word?
Yes. Calipigian.
Calipagian?
Nope, Calipigian.
Calipigian.
Yes.
May I have the definition, please?
This is having a shapely buttocks.
Calipigian?
Yes.
Calipigian. C-A-L-O-P-Y-G-I-A-N. Calipigian.
Close, but it's incorrect.
Tough one. C-A-L-L-I-P-Y-G-I-A-N.
Thank you.
New York finalist, Aditya Rao. Aditya says, the spelling bee for me is an exciting challenge and opportunity. If I win, I will rejoice.
Kanai.
Kanai.
Yes.
Kanai. C A N A I L L E. Kanai.
Correct.
How about a nice big round of applause as we just finished round four?
I think we're a little more advanced in how we're conducting this. We have a better set of wordsmiths that are doing the words. We have an entire crew that's going to be filming it. There's going to be 9 cameras. It's going to be a very well done stage setup. Lighting is amazing. It looked like an absolute TV studio.
When you go to a spelling bee, there's lots of lights and cameras and the crowd is big.
You know, sometimes when I'm like really stressed out, like my mind starts to go crazy. Like, how do you keep yourself calm?
I just kind of crack jokes. Either down.
Yes.
Like down.
That's the way it sounds.
In my grade, I'm the youngest one. And when I was in regionals, I was also the youngest one there.
Sometimes if it sounds like really hard, then I don't know how to spell it. So it's kind of scary.
What matters is confidence. Just getting up on stage, just pushing everything out of the way. There's one light on you. There's a judges panel in front of you. Focus on yourself, focus on what you've done. And we all have this, like, we have all prepared for this.
MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee with the founder of the entire event. How's it going? The 6th year is kicked off. How do you feel about it?
I feel elated. We went to 12 cities across the country and we've got the best speller from there. And now the quest is on to get the best speller from them. There are a couple of returning finalists, so I'm hoping that we'll have a smooth winner. But you never know, it's a spelling bee, so anything can happen.
And can we have Chetan come to the stage, please? I wanted you to come up because you've been here for many years and you're one of the best spellers we've really ever come across, and
We're just proud to have you competing in these bees with us. We wanted to come up and thank you for your years of participating with us, and I think we want to give him a great round of applause. Carabah.
Carabai.
Carabah.
Carabai.
No, the ending. Carabah. Carabah.
Carabah.
Yes.
C-A-R-A-B-A, Carabah?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Tough word. Carabah is K-A-R-A-B-A-G-H. Nystagmic.
Nystagmic?
Yes.
Nystagmic. Nystagmic. N-Y-S-T-A-G-M-I-C. Nystagmic.
Correct.
Houston finalist, Sharav Dasari. Sharav says, the spelling bee for me is a learning experience, and life's mantra, luck favors the prepared.
Pulchritudinous.
Pulchritudinous?
Yes.
Pulchritudinous. P-U-L-C-H-R-I-T-U-D-I-N-O-U-S. Pulchritudinous.
Correct.
Oligopolies. Oligopolies.
Oligopolies.
Yes.
May I have the origin?
Two parts Greek, Armenian, Lithuanian, Old Irish, and then Middle Latin.
Oligopolies. O L I G O P O L I E S. Oligopolies.
Correct.
Houston finalist, Shobha Dasari. Shobha says, the spelling bee for me is a place to set a goal for myself and live up to it.
Limicolous.
Can you repeat the word?
Yes. Limicolous.
Limicolous. L-I-M-I-C-O-L-O-U-S. Limicolous.
Correct.
Alveolar. Alveolar.
Alveolar?
Yes.
Alveolar. A-L- V-E-O-L-A-R, alveolar.
Correct.
Tongly.
Tongly. T-A-N-G-A-L-A-Y, tongly?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Tough word. T-A-N-G-U-I-L-E.
Tongue. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So how do you feel? What just happened in there?
You know what? Sometimes if you just don't know a word, you don't know the word. And I'm a little disappointed because it's my last spelling bee, but there was no way I was going to get that word right.
Mom and Dad, how do you feel about what just happened here?
It's tough. It's quite tough. And this being her last attempt at this, it's quite tough. But, you know, you got to take it the way it comes.
My name is Sarabi Iyer. I won in Boston, Massachusetts, and my message to all the spellers is
1, 2, 3, 4, I declare spelling bee.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you're all good, but I'm great.
Iniomai.
Iniomai. I-N-I-O-M-I, Iniomai?
Correct.
Horient. Horient.
Horient. H-O-R-R-I-E-N-T. Horient?
I'm sorry, that's not correct.
Tough word. Horient. H-A-U-R-I-A-N-T.
How do you feel right now?
A little sad. But I can try next year again.
Yeah.
I felt sad kind of because, I've probably seen that word somewhere. Probably.
I don't know that I've ever seen that word anywhere. You're lucky that you got this far. You should be very proud of yourself.
Pleiotropic.
Could you repeat the word?
Yes. Pleiotropic.
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 Perfect.
P-L-E-I-O-T-R-O-P-I-C. Pleiotropic.
Correct.
Nice big round of applause.
So basically, we've had a very brutal round. We are now down to the top seven, and we're hoping that this will go smoothly from here. And a lot of these veteran spellers also were tripped up with these words, and it's kind of bittersweet for me because I see the older spellers getting out, but at the same time, I'm seeing all this new and fresh talent that is still there.
So you're down to seven, and what's going to happen in the next hour here?
I'm hoping that within the hour, we should have our winner. And then that will mean that that person has not spelled any word incorrectly since the start of the journey of the South Asian Spelling Bee this season.
Okay, we will begin round number six with seven amazing spellers. So let's bring up speller number six to the microphone. Weltschmerz.
Weltschmerz. W-E-L-T-S-C-H-M-E-R-Z. Weltschmerz.
Correct.
Taiga.
Taiga. Taiga. T-A-I-G-A. Taiga.
Correct.
Bay Area finalist, Sherlyn Prabhakar. Sherlyn says the spelling bee for me is a way to meet new people. And if I win, I will save money for college.
Gurdon.
Gurdon. May I have the part of speech?
Noun or verb?
Gurdon. May I have this word used in a sentence?
This early promotion was his gurdon for a quarter of a century of getting things done.
Gurdon. G-U-E-R-D-O-N. Gurdon.
Correct.
Pelicky. Pelicky.
Can you repeat the word?
Yes. Pelicky.
Pelicky?
Yes.
Pelicky. P-E-L-I-K-E. Pelicky.
Correct.
Kaitaka. Kaitaka.
Can you please repeat the word?
Yes. Kaitaka.
Kaitaka?
Yes.
Kaitaka. K-A-I-T-A-K-A. Kaitaka.
Correct.
Proboscidian. Proboscidian.
Proboscidian?
Yes. Proboscidian.
Proboscidian. P-R-O-B-O-S-C-I-D-I-O-N. Proboscidian?
Very close. I'm sorry.
P-R-O-B-O-S-C-I-D-E-A-N.
Thank you.
Mananose.
Mananose. I have the etymology.
Algonquin.
Mananose. Am I saying it correctly?
It sounds good to me.
Yes.
Mananose. M. A. N. I. N. O. S. E. Mananose.
I'm sorry, it's incorrect.
Mananose is M. A. N. A. N. O. S. A. Y. We had another challenge on the variant of Mananose, and the dictionary actually does spell out one of the variants, so speller number 23 will be coming back into the spelling bee. Okay, we are going to begin round 7 with speller number 6. Yulo.
Yulo?
Yulo.
Yulo. Y-U-L-O-H. Yulo.
Correct.
Kakaji. Kakaji.
Kakaji?
Yes.
C-O-C-C-A-G-E-E. Kakaji.
Correct.
Drahthar.
Drahthar. May I have the definition?
A dog from a breed of wire-haired pointers.
Drahthar. D-R-A-H-T-H-A-A-R. Drahthar.
Correct.
The word is sil. And this sil is a young herring canned as a sardine. Sil.
Sil. Can I have the language of origin?
Norwegian.
Sil. Sil. S-I-L-D. Sil?
Yes. Correct.
Skindylesis.
Skindylesis?
Yes.
Skindylesis. S-C-H-I-N-D-Y-L-E-S-I-S. Skindylesis.
Correct.
Yesith.
Yesith?
Yeah.
Y-A-S-E-E-T-H. Yesith?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Yesith is tough. G-E-S-I-T-H. Yesith. So let's start round number 8 with speller number 6. Sententiary.
Sententiary. S-E-N-T-E-N-T-I-A-R-Y. Sententiary.
Correct.
Isnik.
Isnik. I-S-N... I-K, isn't it?
Correct.
Valerium, valerium.
Valerium, may I have the definition?
Awning projecting over a theater in ancient Rome.
Valerium. V-E-L-L-A-R-E-U-M, valerium.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Valerium is V-E-L-A-R-I-U-M.
Thank you.
Elasmobranch.
Elasmobranch. E-L-A-S-M-O-B-R-A-N-C-H. Elasmobranch.
Correct.
Philatism. Philatism.
Philatism. P-H-Y-L-O-D-I-S-M. Philatism.
Philatism is P-H-Y-L-E-T-I-S-M.
Thank you.
Big round of applause for our top three. Okay, so let's begin round number 9 with speller number 6. Kylacious.
Kylacious. C-H-Y-L-A-C-E-O-U-S. Kylacious.
Correct.
Crapaud.
Crapaud. C-R-A-P-A-U-D. Crapaud.
Correct.
Sardana. Sardana.
Sargana?
Sardana.
Sardana?
Yes.
Sardana. S-A-R-D-A-N-A. Sardana?
Correct.
Okay, we'll start round number 10.
How does it feel to be on the finals day of this contest?
I think it's fun. I've been here before, and I guess I'll try my best to get a win at this time.
What's your sense of the competition? Who do you have your eye on?
Well, many of these people have gone to the National Spelling Bee in Washington, D.C. So I think everyone who's been there has an equal chance because everyone's equally worked as hard to get there.
Spillfada.
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 Yes.
Spillfada. S-P-I-L-L-F-L-O-T-E. Spillfada.
Correct.
Okay, we are with Sharab, who is 10 years old. You're from Houston, Texas. Have you ever been to New York before?
Yes.
And what do you think of it?
It's really big.
All right, so you're here in New York. You're competing in the finals. What is your sense of the competition tonight?
It's gonna be really hard because I know a lot of people and I know they're really good spellers, so they're gonna give me really good competition.
Accidia.
Accidia?
Accidia.
Accidia?
Yes.
Accidia. A... X-I-D-I-A, Accidia?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
That X sound is double C. A-C-C-I-D-I-A.
So I'm with 12-year-old Shoba, who is from Texas. Shoba, are you ready for today?
Yeah, pretty much.
All right, so when you get nervous, what do you do?
Kind of like try to transport myself to another place, and then when I'm back here, I'm already calm, so.
Compare. Compare.
Compare.
Compare.
Okay, is it French?
It's a French geographic name.
Okay, compare. See? A M P E R E, Camper?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Camper is Q U I M P E R.
Okay, thank you.
With that, we have one speller who is left, so he gets the next word on the list. If he gets the next word on the list right, he's our champion. If not, we will invite back the other speller who was in the same round with him in the previous round. So speller number 6. Forminx.
Forminx?
Yes.
May I have its definition, please?
Forminx is an ancient Greek musical instrument similar to the lyra.
Forminx. P H O R M I N X. Forminx.
And that's correct. Your champion.
Champion for the 2013 MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee, Sriram Hagwar. Returning finalist for the last 6 years. Started with us when he was 8. He's finally the champion. One round of applause, please. There you go.
That was the finale to yet another exciting and nail-biting contest called the South Asian Spelling Bee. The contest is held annually across the country and registration is now open at www.southasianspellingbee.com. Now don't be left out. Make sure you join in and register your child to participate today, and who knows, they could be the next Spelling Bee champ. Can your child spell? Thank you, everyone. Sriram, you are the winner of this contest. What was the word that you won?
Forminx.
And did you know that word?
Immediately, yeah.
How do you feel?
I feel elated. I didn't expect to get this far because there were a lot of words in the competition that I didn't know.
There were several people who came back in because, in fact, they spelled variations of the correct word. You see these kids grow, and It's just amazing, but it's like a sporting event. You start to sweat, you're rooting for everybody. You want it to go to overtime, you don't quite want anyone to lose, but it's wonderful.